Central Los Angeles, check out the special night with Greg Cady, special guest, Mob James, former Death Row Records security, coming straight at you.
All the way to Australia, and I'm coming to Australia to let everybody know what's really going down with this here. And I'm not holding no punches. I'm going to give it to you. Anything you want to know, I got the answer for you. If I don't know it, I'm going to tell you I don't know. I'm not going to give you no speculations. I'm not going to give you nothing. I'm going to give it to you raw and uncut, the way it was in Death Row.
You know what, man? As long as this goes on and on and on, you're always going to get people coming out with ridiculous bullshit. I've been dealing with it the last 2 weeks with a little bit of stuff of this show, and I just want to be really, really clear for our screen tuners listening in. We are bringing this show to certain people in certain platforms of the world based on Greg Cady's facts. This is not a made-up thing that we, you know, this is what we believe. We're coming with the realness with this sort of stuff. And that's why I'm working for this guy on this project. And you know what? Come July, August down here in Australia, this is the first country to do it. And it's great for certain people to come to our shows. We got a music component, but when Greg and I hit the stage and Greg does this presentation at the end of it with question and answers, these people can do it live in the flesh and actually ask Greg, if they want to ask Greg some bullshit questions, you're going to get some straight facts. If you want to ask some questions that are really, really good and you got some information back there, it'll be a learning curve for a lot of people that think they know a lot about this stuff. They actually don't. Because the feedback we're getting all around the world right now, Reggie, around Unsolved is, oh, my God, I can't believe this, this, and this, because they're starting to watch it on Netflix and certain platforms. Mm-hmm. And that's why me and Greg came up with this little concept. It's not a money-making thing.
No shit, man.
Don't bullshit me.
Bullshit.
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 People keep saying, oh, they're making up. There's no money in this.
Don't bullshit me.
Bullshit.
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 It's like it's a little bit of money, you know, me to support some certain charities and whatnot, but
bullshit.
Bullshit.
This is great stuff, and thank you to John and Reggie for supporting it, and keep up the great work, and one love.
Appreciate it. Appreciate you, man. You know, appreciate you too, Viago. Appreciate you taking care of my boys, Greg.
I got a lot of reach out for some PR people here in Australia and Asia. It was like Greg Cady and Mob James Vlad TV is better. This is not dissing Vlad. You know, I know we've had some other people on Vlad TV, but Cady Vlad TV and Mob James Vlad TV was incredible.
Don't bullshit me.
Bullshit.
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 It was a learning curve. It was sincere. It was heartfelt.
Don't bullshit me.
Bullshit.
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 And it adds up. There's no bullshit. There's no theories. There's no conspiracy.
Yeah. Don't bullshit me.
Bullshit.
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 Nobody can check Mob James. I want to make one thing really, really quick to everybody out there that's listening on this channel. You can't tell Mob James what he went through between 1992 and 99.
Bullshit.
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 If we, you know, pending you April the 19th, Reggie, and, you know, we're praying for you with what you go through and what you believe in.
Bullshit.
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 You're another person as well. I don't want to deal with anyone that talks bullshit about theories and this and that. RJ Bonds, the Michael Collins of the world, you know, Schizophrenic Mike theories, Jesse Surratt. I know where all those motherfuckers have come from, and I've checked a lot of them.
Stuff talk, Bonami.
And that's why, you know, you can set up your little channels and your fake Instagrammers and, you know, call me Cady's boy. Well, yeah, I am Cady's boy because I respect Cady, because Cady's done more for this case in 21 years than anyone ever did. And there's no disrespect to Russell Poole.
Don't bullshit me.
Bullshit.
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 Cady achieved more in 12 months than Russell Poole did in 10 years.
No shit, man.
Don't bullshit me.
Bullshit.
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 take this shit no more, man. I swear to God, man.
He said, shot. I said, when? He said, soon. I said, cool. Then he said, it's all depending on you. That was one day before the 7th day of June. Same week, hit him up was new. I knew what I would do. I'ma play the red against the blue. Then get the whip and won't snitch. Told him meet me at the strip. Stick to the script, don't slip. I stole a Glock from a cop. That stole a Glock from a box. From either the evidence locker that's locked. Pac already shot two cops, so it makes sense that cops went and shot Tupac. Me to the club, give it to an undercover cop named Reggie. The club, give it to an undercover cop named Reggie. The club, give it to an undercover cop named Reggie. The club, give it to an undercover cop named Reggie.
Opinions and all that. Oh, is Glasses still on the line?
Nigga, just call.
Yeah.
All right, Glasses, I had an opportunity to meet you when you were on tour with Tech N9ne and J-Rock and E-40, 2011. I think you remember that.
Kendrick was on that tour. Yeah, my mama died that year.
Yeah, sorry to hear about that. Plus, I know your man KP. You remember when you were at Sony?
Yeah.
Okay.
That was a good thing.
I think at this time, we can all agree that Tupac Shakur made a very deadly mistake, and I obviously don't believe he knew what he was getting himself into. And for all the people out there who go on the gangster thing, Tupac was an artist. I mean, when you sold over 75 million albums, I don't think the street stuff really matters, because I believe a lot of dudes in the streets trying to get into the music industry, that's what they're aspiring to be.
Everything that guy just says is bullshit. Thank you.
As far as you talk about Dre and all them other people, Tupac's death hurt the West Coast. It made all the labels not want to take a chance on the West Coast. And Keefe D said something very smart today in his interview. He said that Puffy played him. They put everyone against each other. And that's really what happened. You know what I mean? I just ask that, you know, everyone just let Tupac rest in peace.
Everything that guy just said is bullshit.
He made a mistake. Everybody knows that.
What the fuck is wrong with this guy? Am I kidding me or
what? Obviously, when you put out a video like that, you're going to hurt people's feelings, because just like people love Bob Marley,
People love Tupac Shakur.
No, I'm not taking these. As far as how Orlando grew up, and what his uncle had him as a lookout, and
you know. Why the fuck you lying? Why you always lying? Oh my God! Stop fucking lying.
Everything that guy just says is bullshit. Thank you.
You know, raised him and all that. Obviously, Tupac came up with Digital Underground, and you know. He learned to, you know, be an Interscope artist, an actor, and then he came to Death Row. And he came to Death Row at a time in his life when he was obviously very angry. He felt like he had been betrayed. He had the world in his hands. We've all got high. We all act up in front of girls. We've all done that when we were young, and we've all made mistakes. You know what I'm saying? That's all really what it was. You know what I mean? It wasn't, you know, Tupac was out here trying to, you know, I hope not, you know.
Everything that guy just says bullshit. Thank you.
That's about it, you know, but this is a sad time, you know what I'm saying, to bring that up, you know, with the death of Nipsey and all of that. You know, I just want to see, you know, I want to see everyone get their paper, everyone live well, you know what I mean, and we all get along as minorities.
You're Australian. Be Australian. Excuse me, Kangaroo Jack.
So, you know what I'm saying? Hopefully, I'd like to hear another Mac 10 and Glasses album again. I think what you dudes did together was classic. You know what I mean?
Do you know what I mean?
And, you know what I mean? I'd like to hear that again. You know what I mean?
Do you know what I mean?
So this kid was hitting him lovely, but then it stopped.
You know what, man? As long as this goes on and on and on.
The kid caught a dry spell. So I bump into him. So I said, yo, what's up, man? I said, yo, what's up, man? I said, yeah, all right, man. And he described him. That's the one they said got his dick cut off, yeah. And the first thing come out of his mouth, man, let's kill him, man. Uh-huh. I was like, nah, just hold up for a minute. Let me think about this thing. So.